Hi, good morning. I hope you're having a great Thursday. I pray the Lord have blessed you this morning. I know he has. You got breath in your body. You're able to watch this video, so I know you're blessed. And so, amen. We give God praise for another day and another opportunity to share in this prayer devotional series. I pray that you have had a blessed day, are having a blessed day, and will continue to have a blessed day. Before we get started, let's have a word of prayer. Father, we come this morning with thanksgiving in our hearts. We're so grateful and thankful for all of your many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. We pray now, God, that as we submit this prayer devotional to you, Father, we ask that you will lead us. We ask that you will guide us, that you will help us to understand your word, understand your will, understand your way. And Father God, we submit our life unto your will. We thank you in Jesus' name, and we pray and ask the Holy Spirit to lead us and guide us. And we pray, God, this prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. So today I want to talk about how to respond when God says no. You know, I talked about the other day that anytime we pray according to the will of God, he hears us and he will answer and do what we have asked, right? Sometimes when we are praying, this is just the truth of the matter. We're not perfect, right? We are not perfect. It is our desire and it is our goal is to pray according to the will of God. But sometimes, the truth is, sometimes we don't. And because it's not according to God's will, God will give us a no, right? God sometimes will say no, or sometimes God will say not yet, right? But we have to understand that God is our good Father, and he's looking out for our best interest, and he has his will. And so how should we respond when God says no? And I want to look at some scripture that we're going to see how to respond when God says no, right? Or when God gives a no. And so there are many times in our life that we're going to get that yes. And we know that it is according, because the Bible is true. If we're lining up with the will of God, God is going to answer our prayer. But amen, I talked about yesterday about we are still in our bodies, right? And we're praying, and it is our desire, amen, and our goal to line up with his will. But the truth of the matter is sometime, amen, our request, amen, is not a part of his will. And so God will say no. So let's see how can we respond to that, right? One scripture I want to share, if you remember back in, I think it is 2 Samuel. If you will remember, amen, King David, amen, when he had that son with Bathsheba, amen, the Bible says that that David pleaded with the Lord for the life, amen, of his and Bathsheba's infant son, right? If you go back and look in 2 Samuel chapter 12, you will see where David fasted and where David prayed for days, right? But on the seventh day, the child died, okay? He was praying for the child, but the child died. What do that tell me? God said no, right? All right. So God gave David a no. Amen. He did not spare the child, right? The child died. So let's look at how David responded when God said no, right? He responded in a way that's a model for all of us. What did he do? First of all, he accepted what God had done. And he looked at it not as God had did something wrong, not that God had did something bad, but he accepted it as God being the good God that he is, and he accepted it as right. See, sometime in life you have to understand that when God says no, you got to understand that God is coming from a place of love, God is coming from a place of goodness, and God is coming from the place of amen of perfection, right? Amen. You got to remember something that Psalm 84 and 11 said. This is something that I have learned to apply to my life. Psalm 84 and 11 said, no good thing does he withhold from those who walk uprightly. I want to say that again because I want you to get this. Psalm 84:11 says, no good thing will he withhold from those who walk uprightly. That's how I live my life, trusting God. I live my life trusting God by this scripture right here. That when God, I'm praying for some things. I remember I was seeking a job that I was looking at, and I wanted that job. Man, I wanted it. But people were like, oh, you got it. And I would tell them, if it's the Lord's will, I'll get it. See, we done got away from that. You know, I growed up in a time that people will say, they're going to say, well, we're going to do this. And they will always say, if it's the Lord's will, right? And that's what I was telling them. I was telling them, if it's God's will for me, I know I'll get it. But if it's not his will, I accept the people turning me down for the job. Did I want it? Oh, yes, I did want it. Amen. But when it came down, I went through the rounds of interviews and everything, got the phone call. They said, Mr. Harmon, we're going with another candidate. I told them, thank you. I know the candidate that got it. I'm grateful and thankful that he got it. I believe it is God's will for him to have gotten it and not me. And because the Bible have taught me no good thing, amen, will he withhold from me. Amen. So I didn't let bitterness, I didn't let anger, none of that arise in me. I accepted it as God telling me no, right? Now, maybe down the road, I don't know. It might be a not yet, but right now he said no. And so I accept that, right? I don't get in a place somewhere and be like and throw a tantrum like, you know, like my baby Gwen does when we tell her no. Oh, she falls out in the flow. Hey, maybe as a babe in Christ, yes, you know, I probably would have had to ask God to help me with it. But as you mature in the Lord, amen, you say, Lord, I know that was not your will. Hey, Lord, let's keep on rolling. I trust your judgment. I trust you to do what is good for me. Because as David said, you are my shepherd. So that's how I live my life. That no good thing does he withhold from those who walk uprightly. So David, he responded in a way that is a model for us. He accepted what God had done was right. And he accepted what God had done was good. And what did he do? What did he do? The Bible teaches us in verse 20 that he went into the house of the Lord and worshiped. Oh, hallelujah. Ain't that right? David hoped for a different outcome. Amen. But God is God. And he, amen, made the choice. Ain't that right? He made the choice. And even though David was in grief, the Bible says in verse 20, 2 Samuel, amen, chapter 12, the Bible says that he went into the house of the Lord and worship. That showed me that David did not become bitter toward the Lord, and David did not turn away from God. David turned even more to God. My brothers and my sisters, God will give us a no. God will tell us no, because even though we're praying for something, it's not his will. If he chooses to do otherwise, let's look at what David done. Amen. Don't become bitter toward God. So many people become bitter toward God, and you need to repent. You need to ask God for forgiveness, and you need to ask God to heal the brokenness in your heart and in your mind. Amen. People have lost some things, and you prayed, and God said otherwise. And we have to learn to praise God and worship God and trust God, even when God gives us that no. So many people today are bitter. I'm telling you, as a pastor, I have met people, amen, that are bitter in life because God have given them a no in life. They pray for some things. I've seen people pray for not only things, but they pray in situations. They pray, you know, you might have a loved one that was sick and we pray. Yes, we're trusting God to heal them. But God's answer might be, hey, they are entering into eternity. Ain't that right? And we should not become bitter toward God. We should not get angry. And we should, as some people I know, I pray for them, amen, that were, amen, church, they were going to church and things like that, and some things happened in life that didn't go their way, hey, they turn away from God. Amen. My brothers and my sisters, I tell you what, if that's you today, it's time, amen, to go to God and receive the forgiveness that you need. It's time to go to God and receive the healing that you need. It's time to go to God and receive, amen, the deliverance, amen, that you need. I'm telling you today, my brother and my sister, David gives us a great example. Yes, I mean, even though, you know, David, amen, the child was born the way it was, I like when God, amen, God made a decision. Amen. The child died. God made a decision. And even though David was praying for a different outcome, he accepted what God did. Right? He accepted what God did. And the Bible tells him he went to the house of the Lord and worshiped. Amen. 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 We just got to trust God. Amen. That's how we respond. Amen. You trust God even more. Even in the nose, we got to trust God. Ain't that right? Amen. Let's look at another one. Amen. Let's go to the New Testament this time. And let's look at the Apostle Paul, right? In Paul's personal life, if you will remember, amen, Paul, amen, had something that he was plagued with called, amen, a thorn in the flesh, right? If you go to 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7, and the Bible said that Paul pleaded with the Lord on three separate occasions to take this thorn from him. But what did God say? God did not. So that means even though Paul prayed that God take it from him, God said in his will, as his perfect will, no, right? Amen. And Paul, amen, learned from this experience. Paul did not become bitter. God, you did not do this. I prayed and I prayed. I prayed three times. God, no, he didn't do that. He learned. God even taught him in giving him a no, because Paul learned, amen, a greater measure of God's grace. Ain't that right? And the ability to live, amen, for the glory of God, even with the difficulty that he was experiencing. Right? Amen. 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 Even though, amen, God gave him a no, amen, Paul did not give up. Right? He didn't get frustrated and give up. Oh, y'all ought to help me. He didn't say, God don't care about me. Amen. But amen, if you go, amen, the verse of 2 Corinthians chapter 12 and read verse 10, it shows us that Paul, amen, chose to delight in weakness, right? In insults, in hardships, in persecution, in difficulties. He said, the Bible said, for when I am weak, then I am strong. Ain't that right? Amen. My brothers and my sisters, I just came to tell you, I want to share another one. Amen. Because God never stops being God. Amen. He's sovereign, right? Amen. And I want to share another one. I got another one here. I do have the one with Mary and Martha remember when they sent for Jesus? I was going to share that, but I see my time, amen, is going. So I don't want to be too long. Let me get another scripture. Amen. I'm going to have to pull it up on my phone. I think it's over in, my other one is in Acts. Acts chapter 16. Amen. And I want to share something else with you. Amen. This is also an example about the Apostle Paul. Amen. This is when the Apostle Paul was sent to travel throughout Asia Minor, but the Holy Ghost, amen, amen, they were forbidden to go there. That's Acts 16, 6 through 9, right? And Paul thought he had understood the plan of God. He believed that he was, amen, to continue. That's in Acts 16. He thought he believed that he was to continue in Asia, but the Holy Spirit said what? No, forbidden him, right? And Paul did not say, I'm going to go do my own thing. No, Paul, amen, listened and obeyed. Amen. Regardless of what it cost, he listened and obeyed. And he left Asia Minor and went to Macedonia instead. And there he started churches that would impact the world. What did he do? Amen. God told him no. Guess what Paul did? Obeyed. See, that's what we got to do, my brothers and my sisters. We have to trust that God knows best. And anytime, my brothers and my sister, God give us a no, oh, hallelujah. Ain't that right? We ought to learn from the scripture. Amen. Amen. I, you know, My brothers and my sisters, I hope this has been a blessing to you this morning. I don't want to be too long with it, amen. But what we ought to do in those seasons when God, amen, say no, don't turn away from God. Seek God even more. When God give us a no, amen, trust God, believe God, and know that he is our good father. Christ is the good shepherd. Ain't that right? Amen. And we see time and time again, amen, from examples in the Bible that I've just shared, amen, that when God says no, amen, you got to learn what Paul taught us, and that is his grace is sufficient for us. I pray you've had a blessed day. I hope this small, amen, prayer devotional has been a help to you, amen. And remember, amen, what I said, Psalm 84:11, no good thing does he withhold from those who walk uprightly. Ain't that right? Amen. So even if God tells us no on something, hallelujah, amen, amen, know that he is not keeping anything good from us. He is treating us with love. Remember that when we pray, this is my final thought, amen. When we pray, amen, it is not to change the mind of God. Amen, amen. And this is a quote, amen. I thought I had the author's name, amen. Patrick Sliman. That's an article he wrote, and I got a quote from him, Patrick Sliman. Amen. He says, when we pray, he said, we pray, amen. Let me go back. We may never know the specifics of why the Lord does not grant many of our prayers, but what we do know is that he loves us, and in his sovereignty always work for our good, which is his glory. We pray not to change the mind of God, but to cast our cares upon him. We pray not to inform him of what he does not already know, but to rest our worries on his perfect wisdom. He said, we pray because he loves us, works for us, and promises to withhold and promises never to withhold anything good from us. His no is actually his yes. Yes to what is better than what we even ask for. I pray you've had a blessed day today. I hope this small, amen, devotional on how to respond, amen, when God says no, has been a blessing to you. I pray that you have a blessed day. As I always say, I love you, amen, and I hope you know, amen, that God loves you as well. Have a blessed day.